As for the bad, even though there are going to be AFL games, there is apparently a fight going on about how much money AFL players will be paid for this full season. Now, there is not going to be the original full AFL season. Instead, it's going to be 17 weeks. The truth is, they might be able to play a couple of weeks here, take a couple of weeks off, come back for a couple of weeks. It's going to be an unknown time. But unbelievably, AFL players are refusing to take a reduction in their salary. Put simply, they want to work. They want to get paid as if they played a full season, even though they're only going to be playing a section of a season. Well, tell that to everyone, including many of the people who are actually putting this television show to air. Well, sometimes work dries up and money dries up with it. That's what happens when you're in either the freelance business or you are one of the many casuals around the country. Another example of the bad today in coronavirus, a 13-year-old girl was hurt. What happened? She was stampeded in a shopping centre today as people were trying to do their hoarding. I repeat what the Prime Minister said. Stop. For goodness sake, stop abusing the staff. And the idea that a girl got hurt today, unacceptable. We also learned that there are people who are refusing to take breath tests when pulled over in Victoria for fear of coronavirus. People had to be reminded today by authorities, if you do that, you're going to lose your licence. Now the ugly, my least favourite part of every show where I tell you about the opportunists and some of the nasty bastards that we share this earth with, including... Last night there was a text message that I forwarded on to the Prime Minister. It was a text message which you probably got or were told about from a mate or a family member. It was a multiple point plan of supposedly what was going to be happening today going till the end of March. It basically was a massive shutdown. Well, it was a hoax. It was a lie. There are people who are deliberately trying to misinform, and by that I don't mean some of the usual media suspects. I'm talking about people who are nasty enough to try to panic people that were about to close schools, ban churches, when the truth is gatherings outside of 500 or more, no. Gatherings 100 or less inside, yes. That's the rules for most parts of our society, and it will be for the next little while. Speaking of the ugly, Parliament will be back next week, but it will be a very reduced Parliament with literally the number of MPs who will be in place to take part in that particular sitting of Parliament will be reduced. But the Greens say they will not vote for the stimulus packages which are being discussed. The first one is already $18.5 billion. That will mean more support for businesses, plus those $750 payments which will be going to pensioners. This is the ugly of coronavirus, that the Greens are going to try to vote it down. They won't get there because Labor won't be voting with them this time. But unbelievably, they say, well, if there's money down the back of the couch for now and coronavirus, there should be money down the back of the couch for New Start, a permanent change for the dole. What planet are these people on? It is the absolute definition to me of the ugly, the opportunist of what's happening here. Now, other things worth telling you about away from coronavirus, but a reminder. Prime Minister on the show in a couple of minutes' time. No break, don't go anywhere. He'll join us in a second. There were inmates in a youth detention centre who had a riot in Queensland today. This is one where apparently not only was much property was destroyed, but there was quite a few confrontations with guards. So even when we have a scenario, sorry, it was in Townsville. Even when we have a scenario where people are being confronted and youth crime is such an issue in regional Queensland, there's now a problem inside the jail that people who are committing the youth crime will be sent to. As for Channel 2, they are shelving the idea of how much of a budget cut, well, they were never getting a budget cut, but about how many staff would be being cut as a result of A, them underpaying casuals to the tune of $30 million and them over-expanding parts of, among other things, their digital broadcasting systems. They're going to, because of the crisis that we are in right now, shelve the plans to be making anyone redundant for the next little while. So, a rare yay for the day for Channel 2. After all, we're already paying for those people to be in a job. In the Northern Territory, there is an election that is happening there this year, and I know Northern Territory politics isn't normally your bag, but how's this for a change? The bloke who at one point was the Chief Minister, a bloke called Terry Mills, he was effectively a Liberal. He was bounced out of office in a coup, leadership revolt. He then ended up going to a scenario where he has now been able to start a brand new political party territory alliance in the Northern Territory, and slowly but surely, through no winning of seats in the parliament, instead winning over of people in the parliament, Territory Alliance now has more members than the Liberal Party does in the Northern Territory Parliament, and they are now the new opposition. A three-way fight to work out who governs the Northern Territory a bit later in the year. Sadly for me, no supercars. A decision also made today, for the obvious, is that there is not going to be, my favourite sport being played, done, run, broom broom, until June of this year. That said, they said they're going to get all 14 races off, including big news here in Tasmania tonight. The race that was due to happen in a few weeks right here in Tasmania. It still will happen, but it's going to have to happen a little bit later in the year, post-June.